Hi Leo, welcome to my channel. This reading is how he or she feels about me. This is to know if you about ex-lover, how they feel about you, or about a current lover, but you do have a confliction together. So this is will you will know how they feel about you, if there is a possibility for reconciliation or solving the conflict or the problem. All right, so let's shuffle the card. So this is for Leo, how he or she feels about me. That's good. It's two of cups. All right, let's start. So this is your lover or ex-lover, and this is their strength or attribution at the moment. That's their weakness. This is how they feel about you, how you feel about them, the possibility of reconciliation. This is the strength of the relationship when you were together or when there was no confliction. This is a weakness of the relationship, the possibility for reconciliation, the blockage for the reconciliation. Who is your lover or ex-lover? Net total as a person, if you reconcile or if they contact or connect you and you back together, what will be the most possible outcome of the reconciliation? If he or she contact you and ask you for reconciliation, what should be your next step or your next action? This is the bottom of your deck. It's Three of Pentacles, so that means now you're trying to be clever. You're looking after your business. You are careful about tricks around you. You are cautious. So this is your energy at the moment. Okay, so let's flip all the cards and start the reading. Your partner at the moment is the Emperor. They being stubborn, they only see the conflict from their own side. You could be dealing with an Aries, because this is the sign of Aries as well, the Emperor. They stick to their ground. They don't want to negotiate. It's my way or the highway. As well, for some of you, might be they are busy in some family issues, their own family issues. This is just, it's mainly stubbornness. All right, what is their attribution or strengths? They could be have a psychic, kind of psychic ability, or the like guiding their intuition at the moment. They could be as well hiding secrets or hiding stuff from you, so you don't know anything about them, like being secretive, or like if they have Facebook, they don't put anything in Facebook. They close all the social media. They don't tell their stories to anyone. They try to hide or hide the stuff from you. What is their weaknesses? They are not willing to compromise with you. They might be not able to commit. For some of you, they don't want commitment. If is there a problem about financial issue, they will not be able to give you what you after. This is means that it's that way, like upside down. It means that they are not willing to compromise with you. They will not do a compromise or commit to you. They're not willing to do it at the moment because they are stubborn, the Emperor. How they see you? They see you as the Page of Swords. It's like someone who's cutting their emotion off, and they don't like they're not romantic. This is how they see you, even they are not romantic either. But they see you as someone who's not romantic, harsh, rational, like taking decisions straight away. Even so, you cut off your emotion, you're not even still thinking carefully, like someone who's rational jump to a conclusion. How you see them, very good. You see them, actually, these two cards is very close, the Emperor and the King of Pentacles. They have very similar personality, but just the Emperor is someone who is very stubborn, but the King of Pentacles is not stubborn. It's someone who is able to negotiate. He's a good businessman. So you have actually a good impression. Like, you give them a picture much better than they even see themselves. So you see them as someone who is stable, stable financially, and might be they are stable financially and the issue is about money, could be. But you see them as a stable financially, as someone who's able to deal with the money, able to handle the money and their business very well, someone who is smart, stable and planning ahead. And at the same time, someone who has a financial and home stability and able to do a financial and home stability as well. So you see them in a very, like a potential husband or wife material. This is how you see them. Okay, so what is the strength of the relationship, or when you were together, what was the strength that you were guys able to discuss and take decision, like anything being discussed or any problem you go through, there was decision taking straight away. You even will be able, you both, to discuss and take the decision, or decision is being made, like you have to take a decision about anything is happening. You not leave anything hanging in the air. What is the strength? It's again the finance. So it looks like it had a lot to do with the money. Maybe you already in a committed relationship, or you already married or something, and you've been fighting about the money. This is upside down. So the problem was in the relationship, or the weakness was this: the money stability. You see them as good with money, okay, but they see you as rational. So maybe you were fighting about, or yeah, like you were not happy post together about the way you were spending your money, okay? Because they the one who's not happy, and they the one who is not willing to commit. So it could be have something to do with the money. Maybe the way you were spending the money, or the way you were dealing with the money, both of you, this is someone who's not reliable as well. Like maybe this was the weakness. They were thinking that you're not reliable. You take the money and spend it, or you give the money to your family or something like that. This is how they think, and this does look like was really the weakness of the relationship. Could be one of you, like it doesn't have to be you, but this is what was happening. Was unreliable, someone was unreliable, was not dealing with the money properly. They was spending the money, someone was not responsible, whoever was, who is, yeah. The possibility for you to reconcile, it's actually a good possibility, because this is the card of the victory. This is one of the cards, it can be used for the reconciliation. It can mean the reconciliation. It's still a card for the ego, card for narcissist, but it's for this position for reconciliation, I will take it as card of victory. So this is a big possibility for you, at least to connect again, to talk again, to take even the chance to reconcile. So what will be the blockage? I think it is the best hurt, because this is it is a big load. The Ten of Wands is about the big load. So it might be there is a lot of responsibility or load in this relationship, or this marriage or commitment has a lot to do with money, or how you both deal with the money, you're arguing about the money. Or it could be lots of responsibility already you both were facing and still facing, and this is could be what's blocking or will block this victory for reconciliation. But it's, I think it's something in your hands, like you both could fix it. What is your partner or ex-partner as a total, as a personality. They are the Hierophant. They are someone who is knowledgeable, educated, wise. Maybe this person is working as in as a teacher. It could be working as in any education center, or like he's someone or she is someone who is knowledgeable, supportive. It could be a kind of someone working in a church. So it looks like it's true about them, and what how you see them is not wrong. They close to that, really. This is what the card thinks they are. That they are knowledgeable, experienced person, wise as well. And might be working in education sector or something. So what will be the most possible outcome if you reconcile together? I think you will feel trapped. It's not them, because they know what they're doing. Looks like they know what they're doing. But I think this is a person will be trapped, or someone who will be feeling that they will be a victim. So this is could be you, because you don't feel comfy in this situation. And this is he said that you will be load in the reconciliation, that's a blockage. So it might be there is something you guys need to solve first. This feeling of victimization, this feeling of being trapped, or being hurt by others, or like trapped by others. This is something you need to look at before thinking about the reconciliation, because that will be the net outcome if you reconcile. So this is something in the future. You need to work on that so you don't have to reach to that feeling, you or them. Maybe if they will be with you, they maybe feel trapped as well. But just this is something you need to look at. What should be your next step if they ask you for reconciliation? It is the Tower. Looks like you it will be like a fight, or you need to get everything out from your heart. Yeah, like this is something like a disaster. It's explosion. So you it doesn't mean you need to explode, but you need to bring everything out. Anything upset you, anything you think is not right, if you feel that they have something wrong against you, bring everything up outside and let them know about it, even so if they don't like it. Because anyway, if you not bring that tower now, it will end up that you will be a victim. So get everything out. So this is all what's all about, Leo. And you might be, as I said, you dealing with Aries, that might be, or you are dealing with Earth sign, because that's a pentacle as well. And this is how you see them and how you describe them. All right, I will give you some cards for advice. This is Angel Abundance. This is said exercise to increase your energy and manifestation abilities. The key to manifesting quickly is to have very high energy level, and the easiest way to increase them is through physical exercise. Choose a fun and meaningful activity so that you will look forward to exercising and it becomes its own reward. I'm not sure what's that to do with you, but you might be you will need some retreat, like take time out and think carefully, relax, energize yourself again by taking time off for yourself, and by this way you will be able to think and have energy to manifest what you want. I will give you one more card from Divine Guidance. If you don't feel that this card can resonate with you as an advice, come on. Here we go. Indulge yourself in your ambition. Your hard work and cleverness will pay off. Allow yourself the confidence to shine. All right, so this card is asking you to be confident and just don't let anyone or any situation take off or take some of your self-confidence or reassurance. All the best, Leo. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, subscribe and hit the notification button so you don't miss a video. I'm uploading new videos every day. All the best. Leave a comment, like, dislike. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you next time.